Hi everyone, marhaba, this is Shariq and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. This is a Lebanese Arabic lesson dedicated to my Lebanese Arabic students. It's going to be a very short conversation between two people in the street because one of them has a flat tire. So what would you say when you have a flat tire in Lebanon? We will find out in a bit. Before we begin, let me ask you to subscribe to my channel if you're finding my lessons useful. Also follow me on Facebook, on Instagram, because I also upload lessons there almost on a daily basis. And guess what? Today is day 24 in our 30-day challenge. Yesterday I missed it. I couldn't upload a lesson, but don't worry, today I'm making it up and I'm uploading two lessons instead of one. So if you haven't seen the playlist of our 30-day challenge, go check it out. It has so much content already and you might like it a lot. See you in a bit. I will turn my camera and show you my screen. All right, guys. We will start by reading fast, as usual, then we can slow down, and then we can break it down. But it's important for you to hear it with its natural speed, because that's how we actually speak in Lebanon. If you go to Lebanon, you won't hear people speak slowly and break things down. That's why it's important for you to hear both speeds, the faster and the slower ones. Let's begin. مدام دولابك على الأرض, or مدام دولابك منفس أو مفخوت. يا الله كيف بدي اوصل على موعدي هلا منا مشكله في ترمبه هون على ايدك اليمين واقفه بتكي بينفخ لك اياه بونجور نفس دولابه او انفخت دولابه فيك تساعدني اعمل معروف Let's read it with Latin script مدام دولابك على الارض or مدام دولابك منفس او مفخوت يا الله كيف بدي اوصل على موعدي هلا منا مشكلة في ترمبة هون على ايدك اليمين واقفة بتكي بينفخ لك ياه بونجور نفس دولابة او انفخت دولابة فيك تساعدني اعمل معروف Let's read it slowly مدام دولابك على الارض او مدام دولابك منفس او مفخوت يا الله كيف بدي أوصل عموعدي هلأ؟ منا مشكلة في ترمبة هون عايدك اليمين وقفة بتكي أو بتكي بينفخ لك ياه بونجور نفس دولابة أو انفخت دولابة فيك تساعدني أعمل معروف؟ Now let's break it down مدام دولابك على الأرض مدام means madam or mrs مدام دولاب means tire دولابك means your tire دولابك على الأرض على means on the and أرض means ground or floor in this case we mean ground on the ground على الأرض دولابك على الأرض literally your wheel or your tire is on the ground, which means you have a flat tire. دولابك على الأرض. Now, we can also break the عل down because it's the abbreviation of على, which means on, plus ال, which means the. So instead of saying على الأرض, which is fine, you can say على الأرض. Here, we're saying على الأرض. You can use both. It's exactly the same. مدام دولابك على الأرض. Madam, your tire is on the ground, which means you have a flat tire. Or you can also say, Madame, دولابك منفس. منفس. منفس is a participle and it literally means it has no air inside when the air comes out, for example, from the balloon or from your tire, that's منفس. And it comes from the word نفس and نفس can also mean breath or air. That's why here in this case when air comes out you say mnafas. Dulebik mnafas. Or you can also say dulebik mafhut. Mafhut. Mafhut comes from the word fukhut and fukhut means a hole or a puncture. So when you say dulebik mafhut, it's like you're saying your tire is punctured. So there is a small difference between the two. When we say mnafas, it means the air has come out of it and it doesn't necessarily mean that the tire is torn or it has a puncture. No, it means the air is out of it basically. But when we say mafhut, We know that the problem is bigger and there is a puncture in the tire. So to repeat, let's say, Madame, دولابك على الأرض. Your tire is on the ground. Madame, دولابك منفس, which means there's no air in it and it is on the ground too, which is also flat. And then we have Madame, دولابك مفخوت, which means it has a puncture and also you have a flat tire basically. مدام دولابك على الأرض أو منفس أو مفخوت. يا الله كيف بدي أوصل على موعدي هلأ؟ يا الله Oh God. It's a way to say Oh no, Oh God. يا الله. يا is a word we use to address ourselves to people. It's like you are saying in English Hey someone. For example, Hey شريك. يا شريك. It's not an informal word. As you notice here, I used it with the word God. So in this case, it means Oh God. يا الله. يا الله. كيف بدي أوصل؟ بدي means I want or I will in this context. أوصل, I arrive. بدي أوصل literally means I want to arrive, which means I will arrive in this context. كيف means how. كيف بدي أوصل, how am I gonna arrive basically. كيف بدي أوصل ع موعدي. موعد means appointment. موعدي here with the إيه means my appointment. ع موعدي literally means on my appointment, but of course here we don't mean on my appointment, we mean to my appointment. How am I gonna arrive to my appointment? هلا means now. How am I gonna make it to my appointment now, basically. يا الله Oh God كيف بدي أوصل, how am I gonna arrive ع موعدي هلا to my appointment now. How am I gonna make it to my appointment, basically. منا مشكلة في ترمبة هون عايدك اليمين. منا مشكلة means it's not a problem. مشكلة means a problem. منا مشكلة means it's not a problem. So منا means it is not. And it is feminine. منا with the A in the end. Why? Because the word مشكلة is a feminine word. So we have to use the feminine form of منا. But if it was another word, we could have said, for example, منو instead of منا. Here we have to say منا because مشكلة is feminine. منا مشكلة. But of course, you can also replace منا with مش. It's exactly the same. مش مشكلة or منا مشكلة. It's not a problem. منا مشكلة. في ترمبة هون عايدك اليمين. في means there is. ترمبة means gas station. هون here. عايدك literally on your hand. عايدك اليمين literally on your right hand, which means on your right, on the right hand side. في ترمبة هون عايدك اليمين. Here we said عايدك, so we assume the person is a female. If it's a guy, you're talking to a guy, you would say عايدك on your hand. عايدك اليمين. Here we said عايدك اليمين on your hand, the right. Basically, literally, you're saying on your hand, the right, which means on your right hand side. في ترمبة هون عايدك اليمين. There is a gas station here on your right hand side or on the right hand side. Here the person can stop at the ترمبة, at ترمبة. Why? Because in Lebanese gas stations you wouldn't only fill up your car with gas, you can also change your tires, you can have other services related to your car. I don't know if it's the same in your country, but that's how it is in Lebanon. So في ترمبة هون عايدك اليمين. There is a station or a gas station here on your right hand side. وقفة. وقفة is the feminine form of stop. وقفة. وقفة. If it's a guy, you would say وقف. وقف. So here we know it's a woman, so we said وقفة. And if it's a group of people, you would say وقفو with the O in the end, always. So always when it's feminine, you add the E. When it's plural, you add the O. وقف. Stop. Masculine. وقف. Stop. Feminine. and waqfo, stop, in the plural. So, waqfe, stop, bitakke, bienfukhlikye. Here I said bitakke, but when I'm reading fast, I can say btakke, btakke. Btakke, bienfukhlikye. Takke means a second. Bitakke means in a second, in a moment, like immediately, basically. So when I say btakke, it means like very quickly or very fast, in a second. And I think it comes from the word ticking, you know, when the clock is ticking, tick, 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 tick. Maybe that's why we call it a takke, because that's just a second. So, bitakke or ptakke, bienfukhlikye. Bienfukh is to blow. Bienfukhlik, blow for you, basically. Ye here means it. Bitakke bienfukhlikye. And we said ye, why? Because it's the duleb, and duleb is a masculine word. That's why we are using it in the masculine form. If it was feminine, we would have said yeha. So, takke bienfukhlik ye. In a second, bienfukh is he. Why? Because it's the man at the gas station. Bienfukhlik means for you, because it's a woman. And then ye, it's masculine because it's the tire. If it was a man, you would have said ptakke bienfukhlak ye. So we're talking to a woman. We say bitakke or bitakke bienfukhlik ye, or ptakke or bitakke bienfukhlak ye. So manna mishkle, fi tromba hon aidik alyamin, waqfe ptakke bienfukhlik ye. And the woman goes to the station and says bonjour. Bonjour means good day, or hello, or good morning. We usually use it during the day, not at night. At night we would say bonsoir, or in the evening. Bonjour, or of course we also say marhaba in Lebanon, but it's very common to say bonjour. Bonjour, nafas dulebe. Nafas is the past form of mnafas, and it means it's deflated. Duleb means my wheel. Dulebe actually means my wheel, and duleb means my wheel, my tire, basically. Nafas dulebe, my tire deflated. If the person says mnafas dulebe with a m, mnafas dulebe, and we will pronounce it not mnafas, we will pronounce it mnafas, mnafas, very fast, it means my tire is deflated. Mnafas dulebe. But if the person says nafas dulebe without the m, then it means my tire deflated. You can use both. So, if I say mnafas dulebe with a m, with a very fast m, that means my tire is deflated. But when I say nafas dulebe without the m, it means my tire deflated. And here, the person can also say nfakhat dulebe. Nfakhat dulebe. It's a way to say basically my tire, again, my tire, punctured. It's the past tense of the participle that we use, mafkhut. So mafkhut is the participle, but the verb is nfakhat in the past. Basically, my tire got punctured. So bonjour, nafas dulebe, or bonjour, nfakhat dulebe. Fik tsa'idni amul ma'roof. Fik tsa'idni, can you help me? So tsa'id is you help. Tsa'idni, you help me. Fik tsa'idni, can you help me? Now, if you were asking a woman for help, you would say fike, fike tsa'idine, fike tsa'idine, can you help me, in the feminine form. Fik tsa'idni, can you help me, in the masculine form. Fik tsa'idni, amul ma'roof. Amul ma'roof means please. But if we break it down, it doesn't literally mean please, it means amul, do, the imperative form of do, and ma'roof means a favor. Amul ma'roof, do me a favor. But it doesn't literally mean do me a favor, it means please, because we have another expression for do me a favor. Amul ma'roof means please if I'm talking to a man, and if I'm talking to a woman, I would say amile, amile ma'roof. That's the feminine form of please. And if I'm talking to more than one person, I would say عملوا معروف. Again, it means please. عمول معروف, please masculine, عملي معروف please feminine, and عملوا معروف please in the plural. Now, if you want to say to someone, do me a favor, you can say عمول معروف, but we usually use this for please. I would use عملي خدمة. عملي خدمة. عملي comes from عمول and لي. Why? Because when we add the لي, which means for me, I'm not going to say عمول لي. The pronunciation changes simply and it becomes عملي, do me. Literally, in Arabic, you are saying do for me. You're not saying do me, you're saying do for me. عملي خدمة, and خدمة means favor. عملي خدمة. And if you're talking to a woman, you're not going to say عملي, you're going to say عمليلي. عمليلي خدمة. So, عملي خدمة, do me a favor. If you're talking to a man, عمليلي خدمة, do me a favor. If you're talking to a woman. Here in this case, the person said, bonjour, نفس دولابي, hello, my tire deflated, or انفخت دولابي, my tire punctured, فيك تساعدني عمول معروف, can you help me please? Let's repeat the conversation one more time with its translations. Madame, دولابك على الأرض, madam, your tire is on the ground, or madame, دولابك منفس, madam, your tire is deflated. Or you can also say, madam, دولابك مفخوت, madam, your tire is punctured. يا الله, oh God, or oh my God, or oh no. كيف بدي أوصل عموعدي هلأ? How am I gonna arrive to my appointment now? منا مشكلة, it's not a problem. في ترمبة هون عايدي كل يمين. There is a gas station here on your right hand side, but the person is literally saying on your hand the right. If it's on the left, you would say عايدي كل شمال. عايدي كل شمال pronounced. عايدي كل يمين. عايدي كل شمال pronounced as شمال. وقفة, stop in the feminine form. بتكي بينفخ لك ياه. In a second or very quickly, he will blow it for you. Bonjour, نفس دولابي. Hello, my tire deflated. Or انفخت دولابي. My tire punctured. فيك تساعدني عمول معروف? Can you help me please? That's it for today. Let me turn my camera and say bye to you. Alright guys, that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comment box below because I will make sure to answer them. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.